Hi, everyone, and welcome to the PyTorch conference. My name is Rohan, and today we'll be discussing the fully sharded data parallel package in PyTorch, and in particular, some of the work we've been doing to ensure it's ready for production quality training of large models. First, we'll go over some motivation regarding why we need FSDP and provide a brief introduction. Then we'll discuss some of the features we built out for production readiness and cover some scaling and throughput wins we've observed on real-world production training workloads. Finally, we'll wrap up with a brief discussion of where we'd like to take FSDP next. So why do we need fully sharded data parallel, or FSDP, in PyTorch, and why now? There's a clear trend in both industry and academia showing that deep learning models are getting larger and larger and providing wins on downstream evaluation tasks as models scale. In particular, in only 3 years, the largest models have grown by 10,000 times to more than 1 trillion parameters. However, there is no straightforward package to enable scaling of such models. FSDP provides a generic package to unlock next-generation model scale. It is not limited to particular model architectures, is user-friendly and easy to get started with, and works efficiently and reliably across various domains, such as content understanding, language modeling, and recommendation workloads. We will now provide a brief introduction to fully sharded data parallel, commonly referred to as FSDP. FSDP implements data parallelism while sharding parameters, gradients, and optimizer states across workers to enable scaling of larger models. This preserves the simplicity of data parallel training without requiring the model to fit on a single GPU. FSDP works by modifying the communication schedule of vanilla data parallel training. Before forward and backward computation, FSDP unshards the parameters with an all-gather, proceeds to run computation, and then performs a reshard to free memory. Gradient synchronization occurs in the backward pass with the reduce scatter operation to ensure each rank only stores a sharded gradient. The optimizer then can act on sharded parameters and sharded gradients. We'll now cover a handful of features that we've enabled on various production workloads. First, mixed precision training enables users to run computation and communication in reduced precision. The API is flexible enough to allow users to choose the reduced data type independently of buffers and gradient communication. Next, we've built out robust model and optimizer state checkpointing that allows users to configure whether to save and load full or sharded checkpoints depending on their model scale and upload latency requirements. Activation checkpointing is another scaling technique that reduces memory usage due to large activation sizes, and we've integrated this to work well with FSDP. These APIs are easy to use and require only minimal configuration change to your training script. Next, we've also enabled meta-device initialization for FSDP wrapped models. Previously, users would have to initialize large models on the CPU before wrapping with FSDP, as they did not fit on the GPU, but they can now be initialized on a meta-device and materialized layer by layer onto the GPU. Finally, we've enabled a few different optimizations, such as prefetching to overlap communication and computation, and rate limiting to prevent overallocation of memory buffers to reduce memory consumption. These features have provided significant gains on production workloads. On a FLAVA-based model, which is a multimodal vision and language model, activation checkpointing allows around 2x throughput improvements on models up to nearly 3 billion parameters, while it is required to enable training of larger variations on a single node. Moving on to additional features we built out for production-grade training of large models, meta-device initialization cut down our model initialization time by 900 times by skipping all CPU initialization and initializing just in time directly on GPUs. Finally, our rate limiter feature avoids overallocation of memory blocks, and this enabled nearly a 3x speedup on an 11 billion parameter language model by avoiding excessive memory thrashing and defragmentation procedures. For next steps, PyTorch FSDP has a lot in the works. We're looking to enable additional use cases that may require point-wise optimizers or per-parameter sharding. We're also looking at improved parameter offloading techniques, such as to NVMe-backed SSD, and hope to build out automated performance tuning capabilities to automate the process of optimizing your model's throughput. And that's it. Thank you for your time.